All right, tell your joke.
Why are chickens so funny?
Why?
Because.
Hey, I'm gonna tell y'all this. You ain't fixing shit, you ain't got shit. So be grateful that you fixing shit. Come on, some people ain't gonna understand that though. You ain't got nothing, you ain't gonna fix nothing. Something always wrong. Something breaks.
I got a shotgun, a rifle, and a four-wheel drive, and a country boy can survive. Country folks can survive.
It's coming. Oh, why you got to be so cold? Why you got to go and cut me?
This thing's 72 years old. I guess it's got a right to burn some more. Lost my oil cap and I had to make me one.
When I die, I don't want people to say that I was nice or smart. I want people to say that mother was nuts.
Heaven help us, baby's got her blue jeans on.
It's the compensating for me. That's ridiculous. Ain't nobody need that. I know it's small. White people.
I agree. That is ridiculous. That's crazy, too. Why would any white person be buying a truck like that? I mean, what do they need with that? It's just too much. Oh, in response to the other thing you were saying about me.
I guarantee you there's no problem.
My guarantee.
They can walk in this damn old wizard wash right here. No way, how'd that sell?
In the deep dark hills of Eastern Kentucky, that's the place where I trace my bloodline, and it's there I read on a hillside gravestone. You never leave all alive.
Nobody's gonna know. Nobody's gonna know.
They're gonna know.
How would they know? How would they know? How would they know?
I can't.
Oh my God!
I live back in the woods, you see. A woman and the kids and the dogs and me. I got a shotgun, a rifle, and a four-wheel drive, and a country boy can survive. Country folks can survive. I can plow a field all day long. I can catch catfish from dusk till dawn. Make our own whiskey and our own smoke too. Ain't too many things these old boys can't do. We grow good old tomatoes and homemade wine, and country boy can survive. Country folks can survive. Lord have mercy, baby's got her blue jeans on.
Let's go. Take it on, sister. Two. Can't you do it? Can't you leave it standing? Yes, she can.
I'm gonna take my horse through the old town road. I'm gonna ride till I can't no more.
I got the horses in the back.
Oh, fuck, slip. You shot my pet. You dick.
I know, baby. I know. Now, I know you're going to start off this year with things looking a little different for you. It's going to be your new normal. And you might not know how to even start it or even begin to finish it. But it'll come to you. The more that you work for it, you just got to take it day by day. You can't fix everything and do everything all in 1 week now, can you? Of course you can. And I know that you're probably sitting there thinking, how in the world am I going to go another day with something like this? But you will. You woke up this morning, didn't you? You're going to wake up tomorrow morning. Things are just a little different, and that's all right. You just need somebody to remind you that everything is going to be all right. Because it always does. You're going to get through this, honey. And if a year from now, you're going to sit back and think, how in the world did I ever do this? But I did it all by myself. All by myself. I think that's the best kind of accomplishment, don't you? You're going to be all right, honey. I'm proud of you.
Hey y'all. So you know, sometimes I do things like I told you so. This is one of those times. For those people that are paying $8 for the dozen at the grocery store, this is why you should be homesteading. Or at least keeping backyard chickens. Because I refuse to pay $8 for a dozen of eggs when I can make a few steps to get fresh eggs. Okay. I'm not gonna say I told you so. I'm gonna talk to you.
Whoa, TikTok. This old Gen X boy is having a hard day today. Got up this morning, went into town, run through the drive-thru at the Golden Titties to get me a sweet tea. Gave the lady $1.25 and she said, "I'm sorry, sir, we don't accept change anymore." Okay, well, just keep the change. So can you do that? Yeah, that'll work. Got that took care of, went to the hardware store, and lo and behold, fucked around and got the one of the different ones. And yep, I used the wrong fucking pronoun. It lined me out on that. That's a little embarrassing. I don't give a shit what you got going on. That's your fucking problem. I said, well, games today. I'll drink a little beer and watch a little football. So Went to the grocery store to get some beer and got up the counter. They said, oh, we can't sell you that until 10 o'clock. Okay, that sounds good. Went to the gas station to get me some fucking diesel. Stood there at the pump for 2 hours. No, I don't want a fucking car wash. No, I'm not a rewards member. Here's my fucking pen. I finally got that sumbitch to give me some diesel. Went back to the fucking grocery store to get me some beer. Got that sumbitch up the counter, throw my debit card in my front pocket. Got to the counter. She said, I'm going to need to see some ID. I said, I gave her my date of birth. She said, no, sir. I'm going to see, I got to see some ID. Okay, I'll be right back. So I got her my ID and finally got the beer paid for. Jesus God Almighty, can shit be any more of a fucking pain in the ass than it is right now? You know, us X models, we're, I guess we're too damn young to say fuck it, we don't give a shit. And we're too damn old to comply. It puts us between get them and sick them, and it ain't worth a fuck. Anyway, hey, Hoss Fly Rant for today. Y'all have a good day. Go Hawks.
I've got to answer this respectfully. It's okay you don't get it. That's okay. I live in the South, but I've been to Michigan in the winter, and I've met guys named Dave with snowplows. But see, we don't have Daves down here with snowplows. We have Eugene, and Eugene's got his rusty chain he digs out of the back of his truck twice a year, right? And he hooks up to the front winch bumper of his truck, and if that don't work, he's calling Carl. And Carl's got the four-wheeler, the souped-up one, you know what I mean? It's even got a snorkel on it. It's coming out the ditch. We don't have the infrastructure is what I'm saying.
See that hat? That's a good friend of mine. Waylon, I love you. I'm gonna tell you something. You can learn a lot by getting a kid's cell phone. I went and asked mine for her. She said no. I said, give me that fucking cell phone. She said no. She put it in her pocket. When I reached to grab it, hell, she went to fighting, knocked her grandma down, and then knocked me down. And I ended up getting a cell phone. She went to swinging. Hell, I told her, I said, you don't want to fight me. You know, there ain't no reason dying at a young age. And I kept on. And what I learned from a cell phone was that every time I took her to the gym, she'd text her girlfriend and tell her how bad she hated it. How she wanted me to lose. And when she found out I had all that fucking shit you get from eating too much raw meat, she hoped that I got sicker and fuck. She talked bad about me. And all I did was try to love her. And then when I went to listening to recordings, that's when I found out she had told her mama that her ex-husband had sexually abused her. And her mama didn't do shit. Didn't even report it. Didn't do a damn thing. And so when the DHS man showed up last night wanting to know what happened with the cell phone, we told him the truth. That I'm an adult and I pay for that phone. And if I want to see my kid's cell phone, that's how it is. And that she knocked my mama down, hurt her bad, just got out of lung cancer, 14 years old. Yep. You know where she's at right now? Juvenile hall. That's where that little girl needs to be. Because I'm going to tell you something. When you go to enable them, those some bitches, if you like to enable your children, especially when they got a history, they come from my bloodline, a doping and, you know, hell raising and running, fighting, it's in their blood. And if you don't get a hold of it, and you don't get a hold of yourself and get tough, you'll get exactly what you want. A motherfucking sign at the post office for most wanted. When they're about 20 or 30 years old. God bless you from Arkansas. Yep. Fluent fucking English.
How long is this going to take?
You have boyfriend?
No, I don't have a boyfriend.
Honey, why you don't have? You look so pretty, like model, cheerleader, something pretty. You like long or short nails?
Short nails, please, thanks.
Oh, honey, that's why you don't have a boyfriend.
Hey, if you call draws under rules, you country is it?
All right, tell me what you see in this picture.
That's an 18-wheeler.
Semi-truck. Here we go. And here?
It is kind of hard to tell, but I mean, unless that's Miracle Whip, I'd say that's mayonnaise.
Ooh, so close. It's actually mayonnaise.
No, it's not.
Okay, this one.
Coke machine.
Are you messing with me right now? There is no Coke anywhere in this picture.
You sound ridiculous.
You will not prosper when the total of stuff you have with motors and wheels is over, the value is over half your annual income.
Oh, I cannot believe it is 80 degrees in January. This feels good.
Yeah, we're all gonna die.
Today, I want to talk about something that most of the people watching this from the South can probably relate to. Growing up poor as fuck. Now, I grew up in trailers, living off of well water, eating potted meat and bianis, bought with a food stamp card, and all my friends were poor as fuck too. I had this buddy named Austin. I tagged him in the fucking video. We lived next to each other. We were so poor that if one of us got a box of fucking ice cream, we would walk to the other one's house and split the fucking thing. I know y'all like that fucking sausage gravy from Dairy Queen. Y'all ever had water gravy? Gravy made with water? You know, moisture? I used to fucking get excited. Today's the day our food stamps hit, boys. Today's the day. I'd be happy as a motherfucker all day at school. When I get home today, I get to eat me some off-brand cereal. Hell yeah. I used to walk in the kitchen and be like, hey mom, what's for dinner? She'd be like, biscuits. What else? Biscuits. What the fuck do you mean, what else? I remember we used to know exactly how much money you had to owe the electric company for them to cut your shit off. Like, we had it down to a cent. Yeah, and to all those fucking school field trips that required $20 to go, fuck you. I felt excluded. Y'all ever had fucking Clover Valley brand cola from the dollar store? I have, by God, fucking $3 12-pack. I guess the moral of what I'm trying to say is appreciate everything that you have. Don't take anything for granted. And especially people like me, I fucking appreciate the shit out of everything. The fact that I can keep Coca-Cola, the name brand shit, in my fridge now, fucking, hell yeah. You know, every once in a while, I still gotta drink some cheap beer instead of the good stuff, but that's just fucking life, boys.
Yo, I stopped over here to the damn store, like I do every evening. There's this little boy standing in line, and the cashier telling him he needs some identification to buy the alcohol, and he's sitting there trying to give her a hard time.
So I proceeded to kindly tell this young man to quit flapping his cock holster and go ahead and either produce identification or get the hell out of the line, because other people got things to do. He turned around to me and got a little bit mouthy, and I went ahead and informed him that you found the right person on the wrong day, which kind of changed his opinion slightly, but he still smarted off. So that's whenever I went ahead and told him the only thing I need is identification to prove that you're over the age of 18, and I will proceed to show you what an old school ass whooping is. Well, and at that point, he went ahead and just left the fucking building.
I'm gonna be straight up for just 1 second. Y'all youngsters need to understand, yeah, old people like me are on this app too. Y'all better learn a little bit of damn respect, or one of these days you're gonna find your alligator mouth overloading your butterfly ass. Do you understand me? There's a difference in the bullshit that y'all think actually happens in real life and what real life is. Come on.
Well, bless your heart, baby, but what the hell were you thinking?
So long story short, we were stationed in D.C., my buddy Jack, my Army Dad, Ellen, and our friend Bubba. Now, Jack's wife, Diane, was going to come over and visit us in D.C. for a few days, and we all knew about this except Jack because we wanted to surprise him. Problem is that she came in a day early, so I get off shift. Elle figures this out. He calls me over to the smoking area. He's like, dude, come here. I'm like, what? He's like, Diane's here. I'm like, Diane's here? He's like, yeah. I'm like, why? He's like, yeah, she's hiding up in Bubba's room until Jack gets off shift. I'm like, she's in Bubba's room? He's like, yeah. I'm like, why? She's supposed to be the smart one. So she comes downstairs because she knows that Jack ain't going to be off shift in a little bit. And I'm like, Diane, honey, come over here and give me a hug. I love you, but what the hell were you thinking? She's like, well, I want to surprise him. I'm like, well, we're all surprised now, sweetheart. And I never let her forget that. Oh, Lord. Good times.
In the South, if you hear gunshots, it means someone's having a better time than you. Speaking of that, in the South, you know, if you find a stranger with a gun, the first thing he's going to ask if you want to shoot it with him. In the South, drinking and driving does not apply to dirt roads. If you get stuck, I got a buddy that'll come pull you out for $20. That or a pack of cowboy killers and a six-pack of natty daddies. In the South, you better not ask someone about their vehicle unless you want to sit there and listen to them talk about all the work they done in that motherfucker. If you see a cop, it's common courtesy to flash your lights at every car you see after that and let them know there's danger approaching. Hell, in the South, we wave at everyone, even if we don't know who the fuck you are. If you've ever been waking out of your sleep because someone was firing off Tannerite in your area, you're from the South. Let me ask you, have you ever seen a fight break out at a cornhole tournament? Have you ever seen a lawnmower go 75 miles an hour? In the South, we all have that one friend that almost lost the finger because he held a firecracker too long. Just how South am I talking? If you see a Subaru with an AC unit built in the back windshield, you're in the right place. You see a tractor in the Wendy's drive-thru? You're in the right place. If husband and wife start to look more like brother and sister, you done got lost. I ain't the South I'm talking about.
Boys want attention, men want respect, and legends don't give a fuck either way. You're here for a good time, not a long time, and there's two things you're never gonna see. And that's a U-Haul behind a hearse, and your banker putting your money in your coffin. So get out there, live your life, have a good time, and to quote the great Scott Sasser, make it a great day or not, the choice is yours.
Hear me out. If I hear put your big girl panties on one more time, honey, I'm gonna take my thong off and strangle you with it.
Up a little rough and rowdy, ain't no doubt about it. Yeah, I've been known to tie one on. I'm the son of a son of a son of a gun. I come from a long line of having fun. You heard about a new age outlaw, and I'm the one. I was born and raised a southern man. I poured mine with rough.
Hey! What's your name?
Tony!
Fuck you, Tony!
What's your name?
Ezekiel!
Fuck you, Ezekiel!
Which one of your decals gets the best reactions? I'll go first.
Okay, are you ready? Not yet. Okay, ready?
Yeah. Move your head back, buddy.
What?
Whoa, good job!
This is how legends are made. Above it all, untouchable. A new animal. This is how legends are made.
I know.
know that. Thank you for sunshine. Thank you for rain. Thank you for joy. Thank you for pain. It's a miracle.
Look at that. Taking the bullet for you already.
So just put your mouth on it. Put your fucking mouth on it.
You don't have to put your mouth on it.
I'm not going to tell you.
You go for the jerry can.
Oh, fuck. What was the point?
July. It's them handwritten letters from home. It's them sleepless nights alone. It's his newborn baby he left with his wife. Mr. Red, White, and Blue, lay down his life. Mr. Red, White, and Blue, for these stars and stripes. Hey. To the swamps of Stripes, 100 stories. It's the Pledge of Allegiance on the 4th of July. It's them handwritten letters from home. It's them sleepless nights alone. It's his newborn baby he left with his wife. Mr. Red, White, and Blue, lay down his life. Mr. Red, White, and Blue, for these stars and stripes.
Go.
Oh, say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, those bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land.